start well, you need a good foundation for the boat. And this is this structure that you can see on the floor, this gray structure. It gives you the level of the boat. Everything that's gonna be built on the boat, we're gonna be built on top of this. So you have to make it very level on both sides, and the distance between the bars must be exactly the same, because everything will be based on this structure. So after setting this structure, you start with what you call the bulkheads. There are the divisions inside of the boat, and they give you the something like this skeleton of the boat, and you're gonna build the boat on top of this skeleton. So setting the precise distance on these ribs or these bulkheads, it's really important. And then you set the panels that will turn into the hull of the boat. So if you set all the measures right on your base, everything that comes after will be precise, it will be fine in terms of sizes and distances and things. So that's where you start, with a good foundation.
We decided that we're gonna travel a lot with our little boat, and Volvo Penta has probably the largest assistance in the world. So it seemed like a good idea to have one that you can rely anywhere in the world.
As an amateur boat builder, I think that simplicity is important. Although this engine looks complicated with all these parts and all these wires, and everything is simplified in a computer inside. You have all these electronics hookups that you will send the information about what is happening inside the engine and to the central panel of the boat. So you can control everything from there. And this is really important for somebody that is not a mechanic or a computer nerd. I think that one important thing is that you can mount your engine and make all the connections on it. It must be something that you understand, and it's not too difficult.
This boat is made of plywood, and it's a construction method that is called stitch and glue. You make large pieces of plywood, like panels, long panels of plywood, and then you stitch all these panels with wire, steel wire, and then you glue all these junctions with epoxy and fiberglass. And at the end, you have a very solid boat, because it's a one-piece boat. All the pieces are glued together. Every single piece is structural to the boat, so that makes the boat very strong and quite light. This is a 3,000 hours job. It's a real long job. It's hard and it's heavy work. But right now we just flipped the hull, and it took us something like a year and a half. And according to the designer, I reached 40% of the construction. So if it took me 1.5 years and that's 40%, I'm thinking maybe 2 more years and the boat will be ready. All these panels here are the bulkheads, the ones that were lying on top of the basic structure, okay? And now we just flipped the hole, and we are rough cutting the openings on the bulkheads. Okay, so like this piece used to be a huge panel, and we just rough cut these openings. And this is beginning to look, beginning to give us the idea of the inside divisions of the boat. Something like, now I know that our dinette is gonna be here. Okay, with a little oven and a sink right here. And in this area, as I said, the head, We're gonna be on one side, and here is supposed to be a shower. So I can imagine myself now having a shower around here. And from this panel, you get to the deck, the aft deck of the boat. So on that big box, you're gonna be the engine. And this is all open space. And out here from this place ahead, we're gonna be the cabin, okay? And I know that the controls of the boat, the wheel and everything are gonna be right here. And from this panel to the front, we're gonna be our main cabin with a double berth, and that's it. It's quite simple. It looks bigger than it is, probably. Here we're gonna put our 200 horsepower engine that we're gonna move this boat at around 20-25 knots. That is quite fast for a boat this size.